नहीं नहीं वो ये इसका रीज़न बहुत सिंपल है. एक तो व्हेन आई वाज इन केरला एज अ यंग मैन आई वाज फैसिनेटेड बाय द फिशर फोक नियर द सी शोर बिकॉज नियर माय हाउस आई कुड सी दम. दे आर बेसिकली वर्किंग क्लास. देयर बॉडी स्ट्रक्चर देयर मूवमेंट एवरीथिंग यूज टू अट्रैक्ट मी बिकॉज देयर वाज अ पॉसिबिलिटी. यू सी मिडिल क्लास और अपर क्लास ह्यूमन बीइंग्स आर नॉट अट्रैक्टिव टू मी because they are not actually they don't have the natural quality of an animal in the natural habitat. You see, so to me a human being is natural only when he is in the natural habitat. Natural habitat comes from the physical and manual labor you do on the earth. So whether it is a fisher folk or when you come to, you know, like here the Lohar, when they were working, or after that, of course, in Delhi to get such people, you know, is difficult. Then I discovered these beels in Rajasthan. So, and plus my training with Kingartha and his and other teachers' attraction to Sandals who are settled around Chandaniketan. So there was always a proletarian class of people who were taking more interest, who were giving me more you know attraction than the other class of people. So to me, you know, it's all question of something. What is beautiful actually? Beauty to me is not beautiful in the normal sense. Beauty of a working man or a woman, the body they get, the beauty they get by you know working in a particular environment close to nature gives them a flexibility of movement and gestures which is not there in the middle class or upper class, because we are all conditioned people. We live in a more comfort, we sit all the time in a chair, we don't know, you know, like I always say, Indian, you know, many of the Indian artists use models like European models. They pose men and women, even including Ravi Verma, like as if they are posing in the European paintings. But Indian women don't stand and sit like that. They, you know, most of the women squat on the road in groups when you walk, the village women. That is their natural pose. That is the same thing which Amrita Shergill also missed. Amrita Shergill made models to sit the way she wanted it, not the way people sit. So there is a lot of difference. One is, so this is Kingartha pointed out. Kingartha said, Shergill painted human beings like still life, which is true because she arranged their models, her models, the way she wanted it. But people don't sit like that. Whether our Mother India or the hill men or the hill women, all these are arranged, three figures standing this way, that way. She has manipulated it. My objection to it, or maybe my learning of things from nature, you can't distort nature because the essential quality of a form is inherent in the body or in a tree or a plant or anything. You can't change it. You have to maintain that which is the inner rhythm of that form. Once you destroy that inner rhythm, then you don't get that spirit. Then it is like a cutout. So image is not a cutout. Image is something like even a highly stylized, you know, Jaina manuscript. When you look carefully, that the stylization has some elements which is connecting them to the, you know, the figures and images which you see in the nature, however distorted it is. That gives them that strength. That's why you can't dismiss a Jaina image of, you know, 120 feet height in Mysore as a perfect male model than Michelangelo's David, because David is only a muscular man like Dara Singh standing there. But here the Jain image is a male image but personified with the 100% that spirit and divine quality of a male image. That is the difference. So the image of a sculpture has transformed the Jain image into that powerful position which Michelangelo could not get because he was copying from the only the muscular structure of the body as such. I make it a great distinction between the Indian artworks, it is the original Indian tradition, and the European artists, simply because we never developed a visual language based on the eyes alone. So the logic of the eyes was not the basis. Their artists based on the logic of the eyes.